What do you do if you have data all over the place and need to get to a business outcome or make a decision? Well, I'll tell you what you do. You use Azure Purview to be able to make sense of that data and bring it all together so that you can get to your solution. And today you're going to hear more about it, and I'm excited for you to join us on The Solution Show with Corey. Back to The Solution Show with Corey. I am here with Pratik Verma, and I'm really excited about what he's going to walk us through. Pratik, tell us a little bit about the team that you work on and what you work on.
Yep. Thanks, Corey, to have you have me on the show. My name is Pratik Verma, and I am a group product manager inside of the Azure Data team working on data governance, which is Azure. Our solution is called Azure Purview.
Awesome. So data governance, explain a little bit about why a customer cares about this and sort of what they're going to be excited about when you show this demo.
Yep. Our customers are really trying to do digital transformation of their business by using lots of our different analytics tooling. Now, oftentimes customer today are trying to combine data from lots of different sources in one place, and they're using lots of different tooling to do so. And they are trying to deal with lots, petabytes of data often. Now, the problem statement boils down to is, how do I really know what data is where, what data is trustworthy? And today, all that thing is managed by combining three or four different product tools together, put a muscle memory manual effort there, use a little Excel spreadsheet to keep track of things. That turns data analytics systems into a data sprawl problem. And so Purview is designed to solve that for our customers.
Got it. And not that there's anything wrong with putting things in Excel, but yeah, absolutely. Obviously, using that to track sort of the source and the governance and the history and the sort of background of all your data sources feels like a bit of a nightmare. Absolutely. And so this is a relatively new product that was recently announced. And I'm going to make the joke maybe just once, right? This is the preview of Purview. And I challenge you to say that fast three times. But walk us through a little bit of sort of what Purview is going to do to solve this.
Yeah. So the first problem really boils down to how do I replace the spaghetti code of different manual and business processes with a cloud solution offering? So Purview is as a service, a platform as a service offering on Azure itself platform. So there's no maintenance of any infrastructure, code, things to write up, no installation, management required. You just, within a few minutes, go try Azure Purview, spin up a Purview account, and then connect, register a bunch of sources that you want to bring under management of Purview in one place, and configure a couple of scans. And over time, what happens is behind the scenes, Purview is connecting to all the different data sources automatically, depending on the schedule you provide, and connecting to the data sources, getting appropriate information, and then populating the data catalog with all the information about where the data asset is, what type of data it is, what is it business data, sensitive data, and then make that really accessible to our users. So that's what we're trying to solve for them.
That's awesome. So you have a demo here to show us the preview of Purview, and doing a demo was in your Purview. So I look forward to seeing us actually see this demo.
So Corey, let me show you what a data scientist or data consumer will see. So somebody would go in and say, I'm looking for customer data set. So I'll just type in a few words, customer. And Purview is showing lots of results about data cataloged in one place. Now, as a user, I'm not going to put in the effort of going through all the 63.7 results. I want to look at data sets that contain email addresses. So with a quick filter, I can drill down and find the data of interest to me. This, SQL table looks pretty interesting. If I drill down on top of it, I'm going to see what kind of information is actually available to see if it's useful for me. So I'll see that this contains email addresses. This was updated on January 14th. I also see that this has a bunch of business metadata attached to it. So I'm seeing that this data set is related to asset management. And if this looks of interest to me, I can open it up directly into Power BI desktop here. Now, as you can see, you can get a variety of information about a particular data asset. But oftentimes, our customers are using lots of different data sets tools. They want to know the relationships between how a piece of data came to be from other sources. So on this screen, what we're showing here is somebody's looked at a finance report that's powering a Power BI dashboard. And through the transformation and connection through Purview, we find out that this is related to a table from SQL Server on Azure Data Services, along with a file in storage. Now, if I were to sort of switch to this view and say, this particular file, what else is it powering for my system? I see that this particular data set is also being used in other Power BI reports. So this gives me a full view across the entire data supply chain about how different data sets are related. Now, the real power of this is, how do you keep this always up to date and consistent with automated scans in the back? And the way that happens is, inside of the Purview Studio, you basically go in and specify which data sources you want to bring under management of Azure Purview. So here's a couple that we've seen. So in this particular case, we've got a North America system, which has Synapse Workspace, Power BI. Some of those data sources are being powered from, you know, non-Microsoft data sources like Teradata, Hive, SAP. And once I've configured a scan that, you know, connects to all the different data sources, I can then get a bird's eye view of what kind of data is spread out anywhere. So in this particular case, once I've kept the data map consistent, I can see that in this particular case, I've brought 9 data sources under management of this particular Purview account. And it's, you know, spread out over different types of data systems. There's a bunch of files there, a bunch of tables from Teradata. And I can see out of bird's eye view based on automated classification, what kind of data sets from a logical standpoint is contained in here. So I see a lot of personal data. There's 7 instances of 7 different sources that have personal data. So with the combination of our bird's eye view and the ability to search for data easily, we're able to empower our larger organization to make the best use of their data and eliminate the complexity.
What an awesome demo. And Pratik, I really liked the visual connections of those boxes. I think it really helped my brain understand this sort of history of the data, which I think it wouldn't work from just looking at Excel. So appreciate that. I'd love to hear a little bit more about how Purview could actually help a customer achieve their business outcomes.
Yeah, so Corey, let's talk about Grundfos, which is a Danish pump manufacturer. What they're trying to do is apply different data technologies like Synapse Power BI to drive predictive maintenance of these pumps. But before they can achieve their outcome, they have to bring a bunch of data in and keep track of what data is where. So before Purview came into the picture, they were using a SharePoint site that data engineers would then go update manually, and they couldn't really solve the data sprawl problem. With Purview, they were able to connect and automatically scan 130 million plus files in storage, powering 30,000 plus Power BI reports. And so they were able to connect the dots together and really get their handles on the sprawl. And one of the folks from Grundfos told us that it would have taken them 5 times number of resources to keep track of the data that they were able to automate through Azure Purview. So that's really powerful for them.
That really is. I mean, it's such a great example. You know, when you think about digital transformation, which every customer is trying to get to and solve real business outcomes, so many are struggling because of the amount of data they have just all over their company. And this data sprawl is a real challenge, both in delivering business outcomes, but then also in things like compliance and governance and understanding sort of the source of some of this data. The demo that we just saw and the examples that Pratik walked through are just awesome to really show how Purview can come in and help you make sense of your data, bring it to a place where you can actually deliver your outcomes, whether, again, they'd be a governance, compliance, or actually business goals that you're trying to achieve. So really awesome, Pratik. Thank you so much for showing us the preview of Purview. And maybe in a future episode, we can talk about the Purview or the background of your skateboards that are sitting behind you. But with that, thank you all for joining. I hope you enjoyed the Solution Show with Corey, and we'll see you next time.